जय हिंद स्टूडेंट्स. सो वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद अ न्यू चैप्टर दैट इज़ मेकिंग ऑफ द नेशनल मूवमेंट 1870 टू 1947 इन हिस्ट्री. एंड व्हेन वी स्टार्ट दिस चैप्टर स्टैंड दैट वी हैव ऑलरेडी लुक्ड इनटू मेनी फैक्टर्स लाइक द ब्रिटिश कॉन्क्वेस्ट ऑफ टेरिटरीज, द रिवोल्ट ऑफ 1857, व्हाट वर द चैलेंजेस टू द कास्ट सिस्टम एंड सो ऑन. Here in this chapter, we will have a sneak peek at the political situation of India. So this is a map of the Indian state during the revolt of 1857 and in the year 1956. This we have already discussed that the caste system was challenged by many social reformers. We have also talked about the revolt of 1857 and what was the condition of the and the tribals. So within about 100 years the British took control of almost every aspect of the life in India, and many Indians had now started to feel that the British control had to end, and as basically India was for the Indians. So the early if you talk about the early political situations after 1850, many political associations were formed. Most of them were formed in the 1870s and 80s, and most of these associations were led by the English educated professionals. Now some of the most important ones which are also mentioned in the book were Pune Sarvajanik Sabha, Indian Association, the Madras Mahajan Sabha, and the Indian National Congress was also formed during this period. The naming conventions of these political associations suggest that they wanted to take issues which affected all the people of India, although many of these associations functioned only in few parts or specific parts of the country. Now there are few factors or few things which created a sense of dissatisfaction among the Indians. If we talk about the Arms Act, this act disallowed the Indians to possess arms. Then if we talk about the Vernacular Press Act, it was passed in 1877, and this act empowered the government to confiscate the assets of the newspapers, including their printing presses. Why? If the newspaper published something which was objectionable. Third, Ilbert Bill, the government tried to introduce this bill, and the bill made provisions for trial of the British or all European persons by Indians. So this bill also sought equality between the British and the Indian judges in the country, but the whites opposed the bill. So these were the reasons for dissatisfaction. Then we had the contributions of the revolutionaries. Bhagat Singh, who was an Indian revolutionary and who influenced the Indian independence movement, he worked with several revolutionary organizations and became very prominent in the Hindustan Republican Association, which changed its name to the Hindustan Socialistic Republican Association. The Simon Commission was also opposed by the Indian National Congress, as it was declared that it would rule India on behalf of the Britishers. Then the next topic is the birth of the Indian National Congress. Now Indian National Congress was established in 1885 at Bombay, and in its first meeting at Bombay, 72 delegates from all over the country were there. And the early leadership was mainly composed of people from Bombay and Calcutta. Dadabhai Nauroji, Firoz Shah Mehta, then Tyabji, W.C. Banerjee, Surendranath Banerjee, etc. were part of the early leadership of Congress. Then in the first 20 years of the Congress was moderate in its objectives and methods. And during this period, the main demand of the Congress was about getting a greater voice for the Indians in the government and the administration. Now some of the demands which were made by the Congress during this period were: the Congress wanted better representation of the Indians in the legislative councils, introduction of the legislative council in those provinces where there were none. Then the Congress made a demand for civil service examinations to be held, which was previously held in the outside countries, to be held in India. And the Congress also demanded the separation of the judiciary and the executive, then the repeal of the Arms Act and the freedom of speech and expression. talking about the contributions of Bal Gangadhar Tilak, he was an Indian Punjabi author and politician who is chiefly remembered as a leader in the Indian independence movement. He was also associated with the activities of Punjab National Bank and the Lakshmi Insurance Company in their early stages. He sustained serious injuries by the police when leading a non-violent protest against the Simon Commission and died less than 3 weeks later. Now his death anniversary is one of the several days which is celebrated as Martyrs Day in India. Period where first reduction in the revenue, then cut in the military expenditure and thus more funds to be given for irrigation. The Congress also passed various resolutions as on the salt tax, treatment of the Indian laborers abroad and those who were suffering, especially the forest dwellers. These demands also show that in spite of being a body of the educated elite, the Congress also talked about the common people. The moderate leaders wanted to create public awareness about the unjust nature of the British rule, and in order to do so, they published newspapers, they wrote articles, and they tried to show the bad effects of the British rule. This is the Indian National Congress near Rashtrapati. We will also not forget the contribution which is made by Bal Gangadhar Tilak, and his famous quote is, freedom is my birthright and I shall have it. So we will be talking about the doubts in the live class. Till then, Jai Hind.